from Tampa Bay's streaming news leader. This is ABC Action
News. Hi there, everyone. I'm Paul LeGros. Chief Meteorologist Dennis Phillips has Florida's most accurate forecast in just a moment. But first, here are your top stories at this hour. The Florida Board of Education will be holding an emergency meeting tomorrow about a new rule that helps enforce Governor Ron DeSantis' ban on mask mandates. If a parent thinks that a school district's COVID-19 protocols pose a risk to their child's health or education, they can now use state voucher money to transfer to another school district or a private school under this proposal. We will monitor tomorrow's emergency meeting and let you know exactly what happens. Meanwhile, students have not returned to class yet, but a Polk County elementary school will close for the next 2 days due to multiple cases of COVID-19. This is according to a post on the Spessard L. Holland Elementary Facebook page. The post says the building will undergo a deep cleaning to be ready for the first day of school next Tuesday, and orientation will now be held virtually on Friday. Teachers will send out a Zoom link for the invite. We are once again seeing more than 50% of Spirit Airlines flights canceled today. This despite airline representatives saying that operations should be improving by today. Spirit says the cancellations are due to several overlapping issues of weather, system outages, and staffing shortages. And now they're offering double pay to flight attendants who start to pick up extra shifts. American Airlines and Southwest have also seen a major uptick in canceled flights because of weather and staffing issues as well. Now here's Chief Meteorologist Dennis Phillips with Florida's most accurate forecast. Dennis.
Hey, don't everybody. Skies are mostly cloudy. No changes there, but the rains are beginning to wind down. I mean, I know there's still plenty of spots that have seen heavy rain on Thursday and scattered showers overnight, but at least those rainfall totals of 8, 9, 10 inches of rain in 24 hours have gone, and I think they'll stay gone for quite a while as we begin to get back to more of a normal afternoon and evening summertime pattern, meaning more sunshine most of the day. It also means warmer temperatures as we'll back up near 90 degrees. And again, scattered storms will be around into the weekend. I actually think it's going to be next week, though, before we get into that classic pattern where we hit 93, 94, and most of the storms will be after 4 o'clock. So again, for the boaters out there, southerly winds at 5 to 10 knots, a light chop in the bay, water temperature 87 degrees. Florida's most accurate 7-day forecast. Rain chances begin to drop by the weekend as we start to see more sunshine next week. It's back to normal.